Halos tumigil ang mundo ni Liezl nang malaman niyang may breast cancer siya. Pero sa tulong at suporta ng kanyang pamilya, pilit niyang kinaya na magpagamot at agad na sumailalim sa operasyon.
Nung medyo kumalma na, what was your next move?
The next day, I was in the hospital. Basta sunod-sunod eh. I had an operation, they removed my left breast. Basta ang sabi lang sa akin pagpasok ko sa OR, when you wake up and your breast is there, then you're okay. When you wake up and it's not there, then you know what it means.
Did they ask you kung halimbawang kailangan namin tanggalin? The decision to say yes, mahirap ba yun?
Hindi. Hindi ko siya iniyak when I lost my breast. When I woke up in the recovery room, umawak akong ganyan. Oh, it's parang in my mind, okay, it's gone. Okay, so I know I'm sick. So yun na yun. Parang that was it. My brain nag-shut off. Parang maybe that was my coping mechanism. Everybody was like crying and depressed. Ako yung parang, so what's next? What am I supposed to do next? Yung ganun ako yung, okay, so, okay, chemo. Okay, maybe I was in denial. I was stage 3. Cancer only has 4 stages.
Ano yung naisip mo? Did you like make plans?
I made a will. I made my will. I thought na my kids, I opened our safe. This is not for you, this is for you. It's like, on your wedding, just in case I'm not there, this is ganyan ganyan, this is my wedding gown, maybe you want to use the lace, of you things that are not supposed to be discussed yet.
Pero ang katatagang pinanghahawakan ni Liezl, bahagyang nalamatan na makita ang epekto ng chemotherapy sa kanya.
Sherlyn and Aga shaved my head. They were
Why?
The ones who shaved. Because I was in denial nga, so I started doing chemo, so nagtatanggal-tanggal na yung hair ko. Lumalabas ako ng ganun, hindi ako nag-hat, scarf, whatever. Pero butas-butas na, kitang-kita na. And then I went to their house. Pagkita sa akin, Ate Liezl, sabi sa akin ni Aga, upo ka nga dyan. Alay na natin yan. Tanggapin na natin. If you want, I will also shave my head. Sino dalawa? Si Sherlyn yung tigalagay ng cream. Siya yung tiga. And then I was staring at the mirror. And then I started crying. And then maybe yung naipon, doon na talaga, I couldn't breathe na.
Or
may feeling ko, matatago ko sa tao, yung sa breast.
Uh-oh.
Kasi pag nakadamit ako, hindi halata.
Kita.
Pero yung pagkalbo ka na, ang tingin sa'yo ng tao, parang, ay, kawawa naman.
At first, I was in denial. I didn't want to see her. Yung time na yun, like the first early weeks of the hospital, when she was in the hospital, I have really hard time seeing her suffer na. I feel so helpless. My mom talaga, she fought like anything she could do. As in, sabay namin, change lifestyle. Like, you know, she didn't give up on it. Another thing for her is like religion, yung mga Bible study, we pray for her a lot.
Sino yung pinaka naapektuhan?
I thank God so much that when I got sick, my kids were big na. Sila na yung nag-aalaga sa akin. Who I was really worried about, you know, was Albert.
Bakit?
A month before I got sick, his mom was diagnosed with cancer. Big blow talaga. I didn't want to show him na, kunyari, I'm crying.
Be strong.
Yeah, I don't show him.
Did you have a talk with him too?
Maybe pareho kaming in denial. Hindi ko alam. Up to now.
Then last year, things got bad again.
Mm-hmm.
Nangyari?
Nag-recur. Nag-recur. It transferred to my lungs. So I thought I was okay already. Tapos ito na naman. So it was worse the second time. I was like, in the first time I wanted to fight. Nung second time parang ayoko na. But I guess you just have to fight and keep
right
going
now.
On.
You're okay.
Yes, I did stem cell.
Ang stem cell therapy ay isang makabagong procedure na ginagamit upang mag-regenerate ang mga stem cells ng isang pasyente. Ayon sa mga pag-aaral, may potensyal itong makatulong na makapanggamot ng iba't ibang malalang karamdaman.
Ni-research ko lahat yan dahil siyempre kailangan malaman natin, kung kailangan aralin mo kung ano ba yung best solution at the best talaga yung stem cell. So I took the risk. Research on the possibility of doing it. In reality, it's available here in the Philippines.
Okay.
So, blessing in disguise, and I'm very happy I did.
What are you most thankful for? My family. My family, my mom, sobra. My dad, you know, for
coming back to my life, kahit late. My kids, for being good kids, not giving me any headache. My husband, siyempre, sobra, for working so hard so that I could get the best. Yung talagang whatever is out there, kung kailangan magtrabaho ng 24 hours, mag-taping every day, go. Basta, whatever's out there, gagawin natin. Kasi in the beginning, may stem cell daw. Sabi ko, wag na. Kasi ang mahal, sayang. Sabi niya, no. Hindi ako papayag na hindi mo gagawin yan. Kasi I will never forgive myself if I know there's something out there that could have saved your life and I didn't do it just because.
Just because mahirap at mahal.
Mahal. So, sabi niya, for me, gawin mo to.
It's our 27th year of being together as husband and wife, so it made us stronger. It's just way, way too painful. Thinking of the possibility of one day losing somebody you love so much.
Your family, they supported you.
Oh, yeah.
Sobra silang in support
sobra,
of you.
Sobra, sobra, sobra. I mean, I couldn't have done it alone, without them.
Does the fear creep up na, you know, pag pumunta na naman ako sa doctor?
If I do wake up tomorrow, thank God I woke up. But I cannot...
How did it change as a person?
I'm more, maybe, forgiving. Little things, I just let little things go.